Now, Honor is a smartphone brand well known for putting out super affordable handsets, but with this bad boy here, the Honor 7S, that budget asking price has plunged to all new depths. At just £99, this is a strong rival for the likes of the Moto E5 Play, and that's actually one of the cheapest smartphones to be launched in the UK in 2018, just as well for skinflint f***ers like me who'd rather spend all of their cash on booze and floozies. I've been using the Honor 7S as my full-time personal handset for about a week now, and here is my full Honor 7S review. And if you want more on the latest and greatest mobile tech, don't forget to give that subscribe button a little tappy tap tap. Thanks. Now, just a few years back, if you paid 100 quid for a smartphone, you could basically expect a piece of plastic crap, held together with sticky tape and the dried up tears of Chinese factory workers. But here in 2018, things are a little bit rosier. Like the Moto E5 Play, the Honor 7S boasts a solid and reasonably attractive chassis, considering that asking price. No, it's not exactly a seamless construction, and no, it won't cause any jaws to drop when you whip it out. But that plastic frame almost feels like it's made of metal, and it certainly puts up with plenty of abuse. Which is just as well, as you might well end up hurling it across the room in a fit of frustration. More on that later. At just under 5.5 inches, the Honor 7S is also refreshingly easy to get to grips with. If you're well and truly sick of 6-inch smartphones which pop your pockets, then huzzah, this thing can actually be used one-handed. And just as well, as Honor's usual one-handed mode is missing in action here. In fact, quite a lot of the usual Honor and Huawei features have been stripped out, presumably because the Honor 7S can't actually physically handle them. Gone is most of the gesture support stuff and other goodies that you usually find tucked away in the settings menu, courtesy of Huawei's Emotion UI. This phone is actually running EMUI 8, just like other recent Honor phones, but I couldn't find much of that bonus functionality beyond the three-fingered swipe to take screenshots. And of course, the usual option to remove that apps tray for whatever godforsaken reason. That said, you do at least have some customization options for the 5.45 inch display. You can play around with color temperature if you like, though the default output is of course best sticking with. And for a budget blower, I have no complaints here at all. On top brightness levels, the Honor 7S is powerful enough to counter any tricky sunlight, while image reproduction is crisp enough for enjoying shows and YouTube on the move, thanks to that HD plus resolution. Colors are pretty punchy, and viewing angles are nice and solid too. And huzzah again, Honor's night mode is present and correct for an easy on the eye evening experience. Of course, as you might expect, the built-in speaker is a bit balls when you're trying to play music or anything like that, just with most other smartphones, but you do at least get a 3.5mm headphone jack up top here for plugging in your headphones. And of course you get full Bluetooth support as well, although there's no NFC support for your wireless payments. Storage is a wee bit limited too, with just 16 gigs in total on offer, and just 10 of those can actually be used for your apps and other bits. Thankfully though, there is support for microSD memory cards of up to 256 gigs in size, which is just lovely. And even better, you can still slip a pair of SIM cards inside the Honor 7S even with the microSD memory card in play. Not even most premium phones offer that level of support. So far, so reasonably good, but of course, for 100 quid, you cannot expect the moon on a stick. And when it comes to the performance, the Honor 7S is unfortunately more frustrating than teaching advanced trigonometry to a particularly stupid hedgehog. The first clear warning of that is the chipset that's stuffed inside the phone, a basic MediaTek platform backed by a paltry 2 gigs of RAM. Not at all surprising really, given the asking price, but dear lord, does that really cripple this handset something rotten. No matter what you try to do, you'll need the patience of Mother Teresa to keep from pounding this bugger to bits with your bare fists. While image reproduction is... just crashed. Seriously, I've known two-legged leprous tortoises with greater pace than the Honor 7S. And even with the usual phone manager on hand to perform a spot of resource management, it's just a hopeless case. Honestly, culling apps and managing your memory is just kind of like trying to stop the Titanic from sinking with nothing more than a tub of custard and a spatula. Good f***ing luck. If you simply want a smartphone to check your emails a few times a day, maybe go on the odd website, then you might just about get away with it. But if you're going to be flipping between lots of different apps all day long, then frankly, this thing will probably give you a stroke. Thankfully, the battery life is a lot better. With only occasional use, the Honor 7S can last for 2 or 3 days between charges. And if you're feeling a wee bit masochistic and actually play with it non-stop, it'll easily last you until you're tucked up with Teddy and well into a second day. And you even get the usual battery saving modes, which could feasibly keep this thing alive all week. A slap on the back of the Honor 7S is a 13 megapixel camera with phase detection autofocus to shoot your super stylish and sexy everyday existence. At this price point, you really shouldn't expect anything more than just a basic snapper for capturing the occasional shareable shot, and that's basically what you get. When the camera app eventually loads up, you can take some decent enough photos when the lighting conditions are good. Of course, anything involving high dynamic range is a write-off, and at night time you might as well just forget it, but then that's basically what we expected. It can also shoot full HD video, although you'll want to stand as still as possible when doing so, as there is no kind of image stabilization. Better news for selfie lovers, as that 5 megapixel front facing camera is bolstered by an LED which can illuminate your mug at night. Although of course, if you're anything like me, those low light shots will make you look a wee bit like a startled badger. So the big question, would I recommend the Honor 7S? Well, to be fair, for 100 quid you do get a smart looking and rugged device with a decent screen and some pretty respectable battery life too. It's only the absolutely dire performance that really holds us back from recommending it, which is a real, real shame. We'd say basically, if you can up your budget a little bit, maybe try the Honor 7C instead, which rocks a Snapdragon chipset instead of ye olde MediaTek. So that's my full review of the Honor 7S after a week of use. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Are you tempted by it? Or do you have an alternative that you would recommend instead? Definitely let us know. And don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell. And as always, love you.